Slater Dell.
Yes.
Ready?
Yeah.
I'll call the meeting order at 5:15 PM. Please rise and join me in the pledge of allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Karen, what's your name for you? No? Thank you all for joining us for Wednesday, February 26th, for your meeting, our first 5:15 PM meeting. Thank you all for that. Hopefully that will work out well for everybody. Mr. Zerlo, would you please conduct a roll call?
Mr. Castine.
Present.
Mr. Conroy.
Here.
Mr. Davis has to be excused this evening. Mr. Hall.
Here.
Mr. Henry.
Here.
Mr. Perrier.
Here.
Mr. Potter.
Here.
Mr. Rosenquist.
Here.
Mr. Timmons.
Here.
Ms. Waldron.
Here.
Thank you, sir. All legislators have received a copy of the stenographer's minutes of February 12th, 2020, regular session. If there are no additions, deletions, or corrections, I will entertain a motion to accept the minutes as presented.
Motion.
Second.
I have a motion, I have a second. All favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Thank you. I will now recognize those in the audience who wish to share their thoughts and concerns with the legislature. Please raise your hand if you wish to be recognized. State your name and address for the record. And in accordance with the rules of order, all speakers will be limited to 5 minutes. Is there anybody that wishes to say anything tonight? Going once, going, yes, ma'am. Would you step over the podium, state your name and address?
Oh, sure.
Please.
My name is Sil Bodro. I live at 18 Leonard Avenue here in Plattsburgh.
Thank you, ma'am.
Can I ask a question?
Well, I suppose you can, sure.
Could you possibly tell me, it has to do with the pilot agreement and for the prime development on Durkee Street. And my understanding, because I'm trying to get this clear in my mind, is that the company's going to get a diminished assessment of their building, but they're going to pay $22.5 million is what the building's going to cost, but it will be assessed at $8 million for the pilot, purposes of the pilot.
Okay.
Is that correct?
Well, that would be a better question to ask for the IDA, because those are the folks that are handling that.
I can't say this, Chairman. The IDA has nothing to do with assessed value. That's between the assessor and the municipality. So the IDA has zero control over what the assessed value of the property is. I will tell you that just because a building costs X amount to build, assessments are normally less than that. But I'm not an assessment expert. That's between the city assessor and the city of Plattsburgh.
I see. So I'm not asking the question to the right people, is what you're saying.
Well, that question would be answered the way I just answered it, regardless of who you asked. As you know, I also sit on the IDA board, so
yes.
You know, I can have a discussion with you should you want to do that.
That would be great. Okay. Thank you very much.
Yes, ma'am. Thanks.
Anyone else that I may have missed?
No.
Okay. We'll now go to the committee reports. Each legislator chairs one of the 10 standing committees, and I will call on the chairperson of each committee in alphabetical order by committee, starting with Buildings and Grounds, Mr. Perrier.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Buildings and Grounds Committee has not met since the last regular session. The next Buildings and Grounds Committee meeting is scheduled for Monday, March 9th at 4:30. And to attend your report.
Thank you, sir. Children and Family Services, Mr. Potter.
Thank you. The Children and Family Services Committee has not met since the last regular session. The next Children and Family Services Committee meeting is scheduled for Tuesday, March 3rd at 5:15 PM. End of report.
Thank you. Economic Development County Operations, Mr. Rundquist.
Yes, Mr. Chairman. The Economic Development County Operations Committee meeting has not met since the last meeting. Our next meeting is March 10th, 5:15 PM. End of report.
Finance. Mr. Timmons.
Yes, Mr. Chairman, the Finance Committee also has not met since the last regular session. The next Finance Committee meeting is scheduled for Wednesday. Wednesday, March 4th at 6:15 p.m. in the room. Thank you.
Health, Ms. Walder.
Yes, Mr. Chairman, the Health Committee has not met since the last regular session. Resolutions 154 and 155 have been pulled and placed on the agenda as a result of the committee's recommendation. The next Health Committee meeting is scheduled for Tuesday, March 3rd at 4:30 p.m. I also had an opportunity to speak to Mr. Canosa today on the coronavirus, so it sounds as though the Department of Health is taking care of everything that we need. He said he's discussed this with you as well, Mike.
Correct.
And I didn't know if you had something to share.
Just that all proper protocols are in place. There is actually a resolution on tonight's agenda authorizing a contract with two places, hotels, that in the event that they're ever needed, we've got the ability to use those as proper quarantine places. That's not to say that there's anything to talk about. It's just part of the preparedness, so that we're ready to handle something should it ever happen.
Have a report.
Personnel, that'd be me. The Personnel Committee has not met since the last regular session, and the next Personnel Committee meeting is scheduled for Monday, March 2nd at 4 p.m.
Human Services.
What did I miss? I skipped over that. Oh, I'm sorry, Simon.
Human Services. Human Services Committee has not met since the last regular session. The next Human Services Committee meeting is scheduled for March 4th at 5:15 p.m.
Thank you very much. Plattsburgh International Airport, Mr. Hall.
Yes, Mr. Chairman. The Plattsburgh International Airport Committee met earlier. Resolutions 156 through 162 have been placed on the agenda as a result of the committee's recommendation. The committee discussed award of essential air service, and resolution 167 has been placed on tonight's agenda under waiver rule 13-2, recommending selection of SkyWest doing business as United Express. Chris Craig, the airport manager, discussed the installation of the clock and county seal from the old terminal building into the new terminal building. The next Plattsburgh International Airport Committee meeting is scheduled for Wednesday, March 25th at 4 p.m. End of report.
Thank you. Public Safety, Mr. Katzlack.
The Public Safety Committee has not met since our last regular session. However, resolution number 163 has been placed on the agenda as a result of the committee's recommendation. The next Public Safety Committee meeting is scheduled for Monday, March 9th at 6:15. That's the end of my report.
Thank you. Transportation.
Yes, Mr. Chairman, on behalf of Legislature Dave, the Transportation Committee has not met since our last regular session. Resolution 164 has been pulled and placed on the agenda upon the committee's recommendation, and the next Transportation Committee meeting is scheduled for March 9th at 5:15 p.m.
Thank you. Liaison reports, Board of Health, no report. Chamber of Commerce, Mr. Rosenblatt.
That's no report for them.
Clinton Community College, Mr. Rose.
No report there.
Community Service Board, Mr. Conroy.
No report.
Cooperative Extension, Mr. Timmons.
Just a quick plug for Food from the Farm, March 7th, 2 to 5 at the open.
Thank you. Discipline Review, no report. No report, right, Mr. Rose?
No.
Grievance Committee, also no report. Intercounty, Ms. Walden.
I'll be in Speculator tomorrow morning.
Jury board, no report. LCLG, regional planning. Ms. Walter.
I'm sorry? Actually, no report. No.
Okay. So, Water, Mr. Perry, Mr. Timmons?
Yeah, I just have a few things. We were looking to have two summer interns this summer to help get some of the smaller jobs that need to be done. We're going to have two tire recycling days scheduled again, one for the northern part of the county, one for the southern part of the county. And we've also been reaching out to a lot of the new smaller farms with our new technicians. They've actually been able to get into, sometimes it's not so easy to get on people's farms, but they've actually approached and been able to get onto it, and we're looking to do some smaller projects for them. We have already got, I think, five or six larger projects on farms already scheduled for the summer, so it's definitely some action going on now. Gotta get the snow to go away.
Superior Board Library, no report. Workforce Development Board, Mr. Rosenbaum.
Our next meeting's on March 13th.
Staff reports, Ms. Keller.
Just briefly, we recently met with the deputies unit for negotiations, and that's progressing. We'll be back talking to the CSEA in the next couple of weeks. And I received an update on the opioid litigation, and lots of stuff is happening, but none of it moves the case along. So no need for an executive session. I didn't hear this.
Mr. Zerl.
Very briefly, it's refreshing that we're moving from last meeting's agenda to this meeting's agenda. So I credit all of you with all that good work. And secondly, I just want to let everybody know that tentative calendars for the entire year, I believe, have been placed in your mailboxes. So although there can be a tweak or two as we move to the year, especially a couple normally scheduled meetings had to be adjusted for holidays, so you just take a peek at those. But and if there's any conflict, obviously, we can make any changes necessary. But those are in your box for your planning purposes.
Anything further? Okay. Moving to the resolutions. Before voting on the resolutions, I want to note that the majority of the resolutions have been thoroughly discussed by the appropriate committees, and the legislature is taking action tonight based in large part on the recommendations of those committees. Mr. Zerl, will you please read the titles of the resolutions to be acted upon?
Certainly. Resolution 153, authorizing Census 2020 Complete Count Outreach Grant Application and Acceptance.
Motion, Mr. Rosenquist. Second, Mr. Kastein. Discussion?
This is federal money through the state that they're working with all municipalities to ensure that proper notification gets to all populations, but more importantly, underserved populations. So our planning department is going to be the repository for those funds, and working with county agencies as well as a myriad of not-for-profits throughout the county who have direct contact with these people. So that, again, the goal is to try to get everybody counted that should be counted. So this is money coming to us that we're using a piece of and working with all others in the county.
Roll call.
Mr. Perrier?
Yes.
Mr. Hall?
Yes.
Resolution 154, authorizing contract with various motels, health department.
Motion, Mr. Waldron. Second, Mr. Conroy. Discussion. Roll call.
Mr. Perrier?
Yes.
Mr. Hall?
Yes.
Resolution 155, authorizing Household Hazardous Waste State Assistance Program Grant Application, Health Department.
Motion, Ms. Waldron. Second, Mr. Rosenquist. Discussion.
As you may be aware, in our negotiated agreement with Casella, we have an obligation up to $30,000 that comes from our landfill reserve. We do not raise that money in taxes to pay for the cost of a household hazardous waste event each year. Since that cost is now borne by us, it used to be borne by the company, we are now eligible for reimbursement from the state of New York. So this is the application to get reimbursed for costs that we outlay.
It was posted on the date.
Well, this is reimbursement for the previous one. I will let you know of the upcoming one.
Anything else?
Roll call.
Perrier?
Yes.
Mr. Hall?
Yes.
Resolution 156, authorizing contract with Stantec Consulting Services, Plattsburgh International.
Motion, Mr. Hall. Second, Mr. Perrier. Discussion. Roll call.
Ms. Gray?
Yes.
Mr. Hall?
Yes.
Resolution 157, authorizing the purchasing agent to list a request for proposals to operate fixed-based operation, Plattsburgh International.
Wait, we withdrew this.
That resolution's been withdrawn.
It has been?
Resolution 158, authorizing agreement with CNS Engineers Incorporated for construction administration and observation services for the reconstruction of runway 1735 pavement and lighting phases 2 and 3. Reconstruction of runway 1735 pavement phase 4 project, Plattsburgh International.
Motion, Mr. Hall. Second, Mr.
I hope they're easier to build than.
I had a problem with it.
Motion, Mr. Hall. Second, Mr. Dennis. Discussion. Roll call.
Mr. Ferrier?
Yeah.
Mr. Hall?
Yes.
Resolution 159, authorizing agreement with CMS Engineers Incorporated for design and bidding services for the reconstruction of taxiway B pavement and general aviation apron design project, Plattsburgh International.
Motion, Mr. Hall. Second, Ms. Waldron. Discussion. Roll call.
Mr. Ferrier?
Yes.
Mr. Hall?
Yes.
Resolution 160, authorizing agreement with CMS Engineers Incorporated for design and bidding services to acquire aircraft, rescue, and firefighting vehicle and personal protective equipment project, Plattsburgh International.
Motion, Mr. Hall. Second, Mr. Kastein. Discussion. Roll call.
Mr. Ferrier?
Yes.
Mr. Hall?
Yes.
Resolution 161, authorizing the purchasing agent solicit bids for the reconstruction of runway 1735 pavement and lighting phases 2 and 3, reconstruction of runway 1735 pavement phase 4 projects, Plattsburgh International.
Motion, Mr. Hall. Second, Mr. Potiker. Discussion. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Carried.
Resolution 162, authorizing the purchasing agent solicit bids for the acquisition of aircraft, rescue, and firefighting vehicle and personal protective equipment project, Plattsburgh International.
Motion, Mr. Hall. Second, Mr. Timmons. Discussion. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Carried.
Resolution 163, amending Resolution 936 dated November 20, 2017, titled authorizing 2017 State and Municipal Facilities Program Grant Application and Acceptance Emergency Services.
Motion, Mr. Kastein. Second, Mr. Hall. Discussion. Roll call.
Mr. Ferrier?
Yes.
Mr. Hall?
Yes.
Resolution 164, authorizing contract with Rennie's Repair, Highway Department.
Motion, Mr. Conroy. Second, Mr. Potiker. Discussion. Roll call.
Mr. Ferrier?
Yes.
Mr. Hall?
Yes.
Resolution 165, approving appointment to the Clinton County Human Rights Commission, Legislature.
5-4, Mr. Kastein. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Carried.
Resolution 166, approving reappointments to the Fish and Wildlife Management Board, Legislature.
5-4, Ms. Waldron, Mr. Timmons?
Yes.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Carried. We have a motion to waive Rule 13-2.
So moved.
I have a motion.
Second.
I have a second. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Carried.
Resolution 167, recommendation to the United States Department of Transportation to award the Essential Air Service Subsidy Contract to SkyWest Airlines, Plattsburgh International.
Motion, Mr. Hall. Second, Mr. Timmons. Discussion. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Carried.
In Resolution 168, resolution opposing the governor's proposed Medicaid cost shift and calling on the governor and New York State Legislature to preserve the 0% Medicaid cap, Legislature.
5-4. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Carried. That's it. Resolutions. Does anyone have anything else to come before the legislature? I will entertain a motion.
Motion.
Yeah. Mr. Chairman.
Yes, go ahead. Sorry, Gracious.
What's the Casella's obligation for running
the convenience station?
Yes. Yeah.
I know the issue you're talking about. I did talk to you. They are per contract obligated to keep the ones that we negotiated to remain open to, that their obligation is to run staff and run. The issue you're talking about, I can certainly discuss with you after the meeting.
Okay. Secondly, I talked to the manager of the New Leaf Maple Syrup place in Long Island, and I asked him about if we could bring a group up, if it would be all right with him. So I'm kind of feeling everybody out, if anybody's interested in going up there and see what it's like. I mean, they make birch syrup, they're the largest birch syrup producer in the world. And I've been up there a couple times, and it's...
So they buy the maple syrup from other places?
Oh, birch syrup.
Birch.
They make birch syrup.
They use the birch trees.
So the largest birch syrup.
Birch syrup in the world.
Is it the same growing, same production season for birch syrup as maple?
Birch syrup, from what I understood a couple of years ago when it first came out, is after maple season.
I'm wondering, Rob, if that's something, it probably doesn't fit the fall ag tour, but
actually,
is there a way to work that in somehow?
Maybe.
I know I went on that one, and it was interesting. I think the people would enjoy this one.
Yeah, no, I agree. I'm wondering, Mr. Timmons, could you see if that's something we could potentially incorporate?
Yeah.
And get the whole, you know, all those producers out there?
Yeah.
I know that group has done a maple syrup, you know, establishment before, too.
I'm kind of curious, does it taste like maple syrup?
I don't know, I've never tasted it.
Maybe we'll have like a birch seltzer that's really delicious.
I have had birch seltzer, yeah.
So, Robbie, will you let me know?
I told my family to go on.
Yeah.
Maybe we can...
Right out of there.
A sort of sandwich while we're in the area.
Anything else? We have a motion, we have a second to adjourn. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? We're adjourned. Thank you all.
Very much.
Thank you.